My name is Oscar Sarmiento. I'm a control system engineer and work for the company Continental in the area of transmission actuators. The business unit Transmission develops mainly transmission control unit devices. They are electronic components mainly used for controlling gear systems. On top of that, we develop different type of electrical and hydraulic actuators, and we have a wide range of sensors and volume flow devices that find also application in the transmission area. Customers are frequently asking for additional information in terms what the component would do when some of the boundary conditions change. It means Continental was required to have a very broad understanding what the system requirement would be in order to derive and conceptualize the requirements of specific components to fulfill customer application needs. It means for us that we have to move from a component supplier to a system supplier. And being a system supplier requires that you are not only understanding the needs of your component, but you need to understand the way your customer wants to operate this device, and also how interaction from different nature is impacting the behavior of these elements during transient or the steady state behavior. Well, the model-based system engineering approach allows you to transparently communicate between different teams coming from different domains. And this is critical when you are developing mechatronic devices, because of the needs and the mathematics and physics behind electrical or magnetic devices differs from what you expect from mechanics and hydraulics, for example. The model-based engineering approach allows us also to understand the requirements at system level, differentiate between functional and non-functional requirements, and break them down into specific component requirements. Then, by having understanding and a clear picture of what the component is expected to deliver, we can roll out different testing strategies, which are most of the cases aligned to customer test procedures, which facilitate the process of integration at the end. That's the main reason for applying the model-based system engineering approach. The selection of MBSE Amesim was driven by the fact that it's a well-established, well-recognized tool for 1D development. In the area of mechatronic system, it also fulfills the requirements in terms of communication with different type of simulation environments. As we know, different needs or different tools are best selected for electrical, mechanical, and magnetic analysis. But when you do the functional analysis, you bring them all together into a common platform. MBSE Amesim provide us the possibility to integrate them and evaluate at functional level. Then, by looking how the system performs, you can also automatically implement and apply different type of tools to derive control algorithms and strategies, and also give insight what would be the expected behavior or performance of a component when boundary conditions are changing. That was the main reason for selecting MBSE Amesim.